Now see students, the rule one is select the longest continuous carbon chain. Remember, so we have to first select the longest continuous carbon chain. Name the longest chain, rule two, name the longest chain. Then number the longest chain. Identify the substituent, rule 4. Rule 5. Prefix the position number and name of the substituent onto the parent name. Rule 6. Identify the substituents with names and position numbers. Now we'll see with example. Okay. Now let me write a structure. 3CH. Now how to name this alkane? So we have to select the longest chain. So let us number the longest chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in this way, this is a longest chain. Now, if in the longest chain, assign and then number the substituents. The substituent is a methyl group present in the second place and in the fourth place. Therefore, we have to name this as 2,4-dimethylpentane. Now, next one. Let me write another. Now we'll go to the second one. Okay. Let us now number it. When we number this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this way, if we number, we are getting minimum number to the substituent. Even if you number this side, the same number you will get, right? Therefore, we have to name this as 3,3-dimethylpentane. Now students, you try to name this organic compound. You can pause the video and you can later check after you try to name, and then pause the video and check. Okay, now let me name it. Now when you number from this side, what do you get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and this is the longest chain, right? This is the longest chain. And okay, now and when you number from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have chosen this longest chain. And the number, the minimum number we are getting to the substituent here, 3 and 5. You understand? Now, suppose if I am numbering from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what number I will be getting? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will be getting the number 3 and 6, right? But what we have to choose? I will be getting a number 4 and 6, but we have to choose the minimum number. Therefore, we have to opt for the first numbering. Therefore, it is 3 and 5. Okay, and in the 3 position, you have a methyl group. In the 5th position, you have an ethyl group. So you have to arrange the substituents by alphabetical order. Therefore, which comes first? This comes first. The 5th position, you have the ethyl group. Therefore, you have to write 5-ethyl, 3-methyl, and you have 8 carbons. Therefore, it is octane. Now let us name cycloalkane. Cycloalkanes are alkanes in which carbon atoms are arranged in a ring. Example of a cycloalkane. So we have to name it by attaching the prefix cyclo to the name of the alkane. How are we going to name? By attaching the prefix cyclo to the name of the alkane. Now you see students, say for example, we are trying to name this. This is a alkene, right? There is only, and it is held in a cycle. Therefore, it's an example for a cycloalkene. And it contains 3 carbon. So how to name it? It is, you have to add the word cyclo and cyclopropane. Now let us find out how to name a substituted cycloalkene. Substituted cycloalkane should be named as alkyl cycloalkane. Substituted cycloalkane should be named as alkyl cycloalkane. The substituents on the ring are named and the positions are indicated by numbers. The ring is numbered so that the substituents are given the lowest possible number. The ring is numbered so that the substituents are given the lowest possible number. Say for example, let me write the structure. So in this cycloalkane, this is the substituent. What is this group? This is actually an propyl group, that is isopropyl group. Therefore, you have to first name the substituent. Therefore, it is isopropyl cyclohexane. We have to call it as isopropyl cyclohexane. Let me write another structure. Now take this example. Here the ring is designated as a substituent. Since the alkane chain contains a greater number of carbon atoms than the ring. The ring has only 3 carbon atoms, whereas the alkane chain contains 4 carbon atoms. Therefore the ring is treated as a substituent. Then first name the substituent. It is cyclopropyl and this is butane. It is one cyclo, this is a cyclopropane, right? But it is attached as a substituent. Therefore, you have to call it as one cyclopropyl butane. Now, let us name the next functional group, alkene. Now, listen to the rules for naming alkenes. Select the longest carbon chain containing the double bond. That is the first rule. Select the longest carbon chain containing the double bond. Rule 2. Name the longest chain. Rule 3. Number the chain from the end closer to the double bond. Number the chain from the end closer to the double bond. Rule 4. Indicate the position of the double bond by the number of the first carbon atom involved in the double bond. Rule 5 is alkyl group and other substituents are numbered, named and placed as prefixes in an alphabetical order. Now, let us see with an example. Now, see students, how will you name this alkene? You have to number in such a way that the double bond gets minimum number. Okay? So, we have to number 1, 2, 3. Double bond gets minimum number. And therefore, it is what? Propene. And that can be written as, it's understood that it is one propene. So you need not even put the number. Now look into this one. How to name this? You have to first select the longest carbon chain. So containing the double bond. So we will select this longest carbon chain containing the double bond. This is, we have selected. 1, 2, 3. Okay, and the methyl group is in the second place and give the minimum number to the double bond. So it is 2-methylpropene. 2-methylpropene. Understood. Now see students, let us learn, try to number, name this alkene. How will you number this alkene? You have to number it in such a way that the double bond get minimum number. So we have to number it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So if you know, and where is the methyl group? Methyl group is in the second place. So how to name this? It is 2-methyl. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is 2-methyl, 2-pentene.